If you find yourself struggling with noisy photos, then the new DeNoise tool in Lightroom is for you. So today I'm going to show you how you would use the tool and give you four tips so that you can get the best results and get rid of noise in your photos in seconds. So hello there, my name is Audrianne, founder of Live Snap Love and the Photography Made Simple podcast, where I aim to give you the tools and resources you need to help you capture the beauty of your days through photography. So we all struggle with noise in our images from time to time, and this can lead to our images not looking as sharp or as clear as we would like. And this can be more of a problem if you shoot with a crop frame camera, so they don't tend to handle noise as well as their full frame counterparts. Now, although you should definitely try your best to minimize noise in camera, there are times when it simply can't be avoided. And that is when the DeNoise tool in Lightroom comes in. Now, the good news is getting rid of that noise could not be simpler, and it is a game changer for your photos. So if you aren't yet using this feature of Lightroom, go start using it now. And if you're not yet using Lightroom, then this is a fantastic reason to get the program. So let's kick things off with where you'll find this. So in Lightroom, you'll go to the Develop module, then over to the panels on the right-hand side, and then choose the Detail panel. And in there, you will find a button called DeNoise. So to use this, all you need to do is click on that button, and you'll see that another dialog box opens up. Now it will have DeNoise checked, and there's a slider there where you can control the amount of noise reduction. Now the standard that pops up is 50. I would say that is generally a good number to use. I use it anywhere between 50 and 60. The more noise reduction you do, the more it has a danger of smoothing out areas that you want to keep sharp. But if you keep this between 50 and 60 or less, if you want to, then that is a good place to leave it. So I tend not to go above that. Now in that dialog box, you'll also see a little preview screen. And this is where you can see the effect applied. And if you click on it, you'll see the noise. And if you let go, it will show you the enhanced version. Now there's also a little hand there. You just click and drag around the image. So I tend to click and drag to an image that has a lot of noise. So we're looking at areas that are in shadow. And I also tend to click and drag to an area that I want to ensure remains sharp, for example, the eyes in a portrait. So I'm kind of in looking at the whole image, making sure that enough noise reduction has been applied, but also making sure that there's enough sharpness in the areas that I want to remain sharp. Now, one more thing I want to draw your attention to, you'll see an option called Create Stack. And I always have that checked. That just means that the image that is going to be created by Lightroom will sit stacked on top of the original. So that's one thing to keep in mind, that what this will do is we'll apply it to the original image, but then it creates a new copy for you. So I have that checked, Create Stack, and then all you need to do is click on the blue Enhance button that you'll see there. And Lightroom is going to get to work using this artificial intelligence in order to remove the noise in your photo. And it does a fantastic job, I have to say. It will remove normal noise, it will remove color noise, and it also appears to apply a little bit of sharpening as well, giving you a really good final look to your image. Now, while it is working, after you've pressed that button, you'll see that it's doing something. There's a little circle next to where the DeNoise button is, and there is a progress bar over on the top left. But usually this takes under a minute to do, and it's well worth the wait, let me tell you. Now, as I said, what this does is create a separate file for you. So in your film strip in Lightroom, you will see this as two separate images. If you have them stacked, you'll see the number two. Just click on that and that will open up both of the images. So you'll see that you have this new image, and they call that enhanced-nr. So it's your original file name and then enhanced-nr at the end. And then you will also have your original image. So the original image won't have that noise reduction applied, but the one that has the enhanced NR does. Now you can zoom in just to have a little look, and again I tend to do that when it's back to full size, just again looking at the shadow areas, making sure there's not too much noise, and just making sure that the areas that I want sharp are sharp. Now you can just zoom into 100%, that's all you really need to do. If you zoom into 300, you will be able to see any noise a lot more clearly, but there's really no need to do that. If you wish, you can also compare the two images, just select them both, then go up to View on the top toolbar, and then you can do Compare. And then you'll see them side by side, the image before you had the noise reduction applied, and then the noise reduction after. There's no real need to do this. It can sometimes just be quite satisfying to see how much noise reduction has actually been applied. Now that we know how this works, here are a few different tips to help you use this tool more effectively. So the first thing to note is that this only works on RAW files, so it will not work on a JPEG image. Now that may change in the future, but right now you'll only be able to do this on a RAW file. So if you don't yet shoot in RAW, this is a fantastic reason to make sure that you make the switch from JPEG to RAW. The second tip I have for you is to make sure that you do this early on in your workflow. Now for me personally, I like to do this after I have made basic adjustments, so change the white balance and the exposure and so on, but before I have done anything else. Now the reason we want to do this early on in our workflow is that first of all, if we make changes to things like texture and clarity, we may then have to go back and change them after noise reduction has been applied. Remember, that's adding that little bit of sharpening to your photo. And if you have too much texture or clarity, that might make it look a little bit crunchy. But the main reason is we definitely want to do this before we've used either any of the masking tools or any of the healing or clone tools. And that's because it would take a lot longer. It's then got to make these adjustments to each individual change that you've made. But also, and most importantly, there can be shifts in color and tone if you apply the noise reduction later. So make sure that you do this early on in your workflow. As I say, for me, this is after I have done any white balance and exposure changes, and definitely before you've done any healing or masking on your image. Now, if you're not sure of a typical Lightroom workflow, then can I suggest that you go and get my free Lightroom Starter Kit. You'll get a full editing checklist, plus you will get a guide to importing and exporting, and a number of presets to help speed up your workflow. So make sure you grab that by going to livesnaplove.com/Lightroom-starter-kit. I'll also leave a link to it around wherever you are enjoying this episode. Okay, so tip number three is that you can only apply denoise once. If you go down to the detail panel, you'll see that the denoise button is grayed out and it will say denoise has been applied to this photo. So you can't go back and do it again to that enhanced version. But if you do want to do it, all you need to do is go back to the original version and you'll see you have the denoise button there again. So go back to the original, click on denoise, and it will run through it and spit out another copy of the image for you. And finally, tip number four is that you can still use manual noise reduction. You'll see this just underneath that denoise button. You might need to click on the triangle to actually see the sliders. And this is where you can remove normal noise or a bit more color noise as well. So if you have applied it to your image, it hasn't removed quite enough, you could come in here and remove a little bit more. Now, of course, you could just do manual noise reduction from the start and don't use denoise. However, I don't recommend that. I have tried it. I have experimented with doing manual noise reduction on one image and then on the same image running denoise to see the difference. And I have to say, denoise does a lot better at removing all the noise whilst really keeping the image sharp. So it is definitely a lot better to use. So there you have it. That is how you use the denoise feature in Lightroom and some tips for helping you make the most of it. Now, as always, thank you so, so much for being here. And if you enjoyed this episode, be sure to subscribe. I post lots of photography tutorials for beginners, tips to help you level up your photos beyond that, non-techie gear reviews, and tons of photography inspiration with everything from child photography poses to macro photography ideas. So do be sure to subscribe wherever you're currently enjoying this episode. So thanks again, and I will see you again, same time, same place next week. Bye for now.